Hey, what's going on, everyone? So this is gonna be, this is what I'm working on right now, and this is a, it's gonna be a drawing of a, of an African wild dog. Right now, I just have the outline. So what I'm gonna be starting now is the indentation, the hair. So this drawing is gonna measure 16 by 20, so it's gonna be pretty big. So I'm really excited about this one. So let's get started, I guess. And most of this is gonna be, it's not gonna be that exciting because this is what usually takes the longest, but yeah, I'll record it. And if you have any questions, just comment and I'll get back to you. So let's go. And for this, I'll be using this stylus. This is primarily used for sculpting, but it works great for this. For this step. So let's go. You might not be able to see much. Like I said, it's not the most exciting step, but it needs to be done. And after this, I think I'm going to be doing another large drawing. And then I was going to measure again. It's going to measure 30 by 40 inches. And then once that one's done, I'm going to work on another large one. But that one's going to be a self-portrait. Which, that one I'm really excited about because I've been finding that one for a while though. I've taken the pictures and I'll get started on that one. So yeah, it should be interesting. Believe it or not, I've never done a self-portrait, so that one's gonna be, it's gonna be my first, and it's gonna be a large scale. I have an idea of how I want it to look. And hopefully it turns out the way I want it. Should be exciting. Well, hopefully you can all join me and keep me company while I work on that one. I know you probably can't see much from that distance. But all this right here, it's gonna be all hair, so I've got a long way to go. also preparing a drawing that I recently sold. I'm excited about that one because I'm going to be hand delivering it, which I don't do often. I wish I could deliver all my artwork in person, but it's just not possible. But for this one, the buyer lives in the same city as me, so tomorrow I'm going to be dropping it off. And it's this one right here. I don't know if you could see it, but yeah, it's this one. So I'll be putting it in a frame and then I'm going to be dropping it off. You know, I love drawing tigers for this reason right here. They're so beautiful. So I can't wait till they see it. You know, recently, it's always great. I love seeing the reaction from people. I love seeing, it makes me feel good about my artwork. And recently I was at a show, and it was the first time that I was showing the black bear. And this person came up to me, and she started talking to me, and she started telling me that she's seen the progress for the bear online, and that she was happy and excited to be able to be there to see it in person. And then she got emotional, like she started tearing up, and I don't know, it was such a great feeling knowing that your artwork is able to cause that emotion. Was definitely an amazing experience. See, my goal with this one is to make it as detailed as possible. See, with this drawing, I think I'm taking a different approach. Usually I have a reference, so I'm using reference for hair, but for this one I'll be working from experience. So the type of hair that I add, the texture, the flow, and all that, I'm gonna be doing it from memory, or from what I think looks good. So it'll probably look completely different than the reference. You know, I like drawing messy hair. And when I say messy hair, I mean hair that looks textured. At least that's my plan. Hopefully it works out. See, these dogs too, I love drawing these dogs. I just love the, they're not as big as other hunters, like lions and hyenas and, but I just love the way they hunt, their teamwork. I've seen a video of, it's an overhead shot of how they hunt. It's amazing how they organize themselves. So you have some that direct that prey into an ambush, and then there's a couple that are waiting up ahead. And I love that organization that they have. Well, so I have this one living within 2 weeks. So I gotta put in a lot of hours into this one. It's doable, it just it's gonna take a lot of work. And it looks like I'm not doing anything, but if you If you're seeing what I'm seeing, if you see what I'm seeing, you'll see. You would see that there's a lot going on down here. And once I start adding the pencil, then you begin to see. It's like, for me, it's like magic. Once I add the pencil, it just everything just jumps out. See, the reason I work from this way up is because every layer moving this way overlaps a layer before it. So it makes sense. I'm usually listening to music, but I can't, because if I do YouTube, it's gonna just not remove the video. Well, they probably can, but it's too much problems. So I finished that first layer. So now I've got to move up. Move on to the next one. Thing about this is that as you get larger in scale, the hair changes, so the hair gets longer. So I gotta make sure I keep it the correct length. Because this distance is not the same if I were to be drawing a smaller. So I gotta make sure the hair looks proportional. That makes sense. So this layer, there's one layer here, and then there's a layer above that. So I'll be working on, again, I work from the layer up, from layers below, and I move up. I really need to get a better streaming system. Because it seems to be lagging. If this doesn't work out, then I'll just stick to making videos. But this, what you're seeing right now, it's what I do every single day. So that's why I thought I'd do it live, I'd do it on stream. To get better hardware. I'll keep this video 30 minutes long. I don't want to make it too long because I know it's not the best quality right now, but hopefully it'll change with time. Just this bit right here. It's taking me half an hour. And that's a first layer, because after this I'm gonna go over it again with to add thicker hair. So it's, again, lots of work goes into the hair. But that's what gives my drawings the texture and the realism. So yeah, so then after I'll go in and I'll add individual loose hairs. said, it looks like I'm not doing anything. But there's a lot going on down here. See this hair right here? This is much longer. See, I did another African wild dog. Hold on, let me show you. Hold on. See, there's this one. It's actually, it looks very similar. They're both facing the same direction. So they're both facing this way. Well, this is a print. The original one I sold, I think it was like 2 years ago. But these are prints. Well, these are the closest you can get to the original, because these are hand embellished. Like I think I have a video. I posted a video before explaining. So this print has pencil, and it also has indentations. So it's as close as you can get to the original drawing. At a much, much cheaper price, right? Anyways, I'll post. There's a link in the description below if anyone's interested in a print like this. Yeah, so this is the first African wild dog that I did. You can probably see the pencil sheen from the pencil. So yeah, so this is this one looks pretty similar. Again, it's facing the same direction as the other one. And the reference image that I'm using is from a photographer who contacted me, and he went on an African safari for his honeymoon. And he took this picture. And he contacted me and he told me, you know what, I love your artwork and I would love for you to draw one of my pictures. So he offered this picture. It's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful picture. So I hope I can do it justice, and it looks amazing. Yeah, but the other dog that I just showed you, that one measured 11 by 14, the original. And this one is gonna measure 16 by 20, so it's gonna be a bit larger. If the streaming doesn't work out, I'll do pre-recorded videos, like 1 hour long pre-recorded videos, and I'll just add those. Because that way, the quality is better. It's not as choppy or as... I don't know how it's looking right now, but hopefully it's not as bad as I'm imagining. So when I watch it, if it doesn't look good, then I'll just upload pre-recorded videos. Again, if you have any questions, you can always comment, leave them in the comment section. Yeah, but for now, you know what? I'll just stop it right here because I'll just test it out. So for you guys that did join me in the war here, thank you. I appreciate it. And hope you guys come back. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and give it a thumbs up. And check out all my other social accounts. They're all in the description below. So, thanks for watching again, and I'll see you guys next time.